Where are we, Luce?
Simmons Yat.
Which is on the border of England and Wales. That down there is the River Wye, as you can see. It's a lovely view. And this is the start of our little trip in the Forest of Dean. Tomorrow or possibly Sunday. We're still at Simmons Yat, but this is the view from the other side. As you can see, it's pretty spectacular. On a walk in the Forest of Dean, as you can see, nice view on something called the Sculpture Trail, and every so often there's something like this. I think there's 17 of them all the way around the walk. And Luce is behind here. Yep. Dog.
This is my big chair. So I can look out over the forest. Make sure all my deers are okay and my little huggy pigs.
That we haven't seen yet.
Beds in there, and then you come in here, and this is the living area. The living area. Just see Lucy there in the hot tub outside. Kitchen. Now, obviously, I've got the football set up. Genius. And we're going to join Lucy. Yep, that's cold. It's really cold. Go in. There's our pet squirrel we've adopted.
It's called Squiznet.
He's enjoying himself. So if you see up there, we put some fat balls on the tree there and over there, and he managed to, the one on that tree over there, he bit through it and took the whole lot.
It might not have been Squiznet.
I think though. It was him. He keeps coming back. And I don't know if you'll see, but we have a rat.
He He's a woodland rat. He's called
it doesn't
Rattigan.
Matter. Here he is. Here he is. Good timing.
It's called Rattigan.
And there he is, look.
His Squiznet and the birds
are there's another squirrel right behind him watching him. That's coming in now. Look at Ratty. He keeps making an appearance. This could all kick off in a minute. We've got Mr. Squirrel there. Rat boy down there. Oh, there he is again. There goes Ratty. He'll be back. Uh oh. There could be trouble at mill here.
Why?
Could be a squirrel fight. Here we go. It's on. Here we go.
Uh
oh. Yeah.
Oh gosh.
They're down here now.
He's protecting his territory.
Oh. You're going mad for it. I don't know where they are. There they are.
Should we test? Where
they are? They've gone now.
You may recognise the Harris Hawk, and the reason I say that is because these are the most common bird of prey used in captivity in Britain. They're not British, they come from America, Central and South America, really, put it broadly, but they are very, very popular in captivity in Britain. And there's a number of reasons why that's the case. Fatlar is just come in his second year, so he's not quite 2 years old, but he will be this year. And he was actually bred by Mark.
It means that I can give her a moving target because the Falcon family, unlike the Hawks, who are sort of stop-start sprinters, if you like, who do short bursts of flying, the Falcons are the speed merchants of the bird of prey world, the Ferraris, if you like, but also the endurance runners. They will stay in the air and chase down their prey for minutes on end. And so that's what we're going to show you here. I give her a moving target which replicates the... Don't even think about it. Thank you. Which replicates the birds that she would naturally be wanting to catch in the wild. So what you can see is I'm presenting the lure to her. I'm putting it out like this and then pulling it away. Now, a lot of people do ask us, isn't it teasing the bird? Is it a bit cruel to pull it away? Now, let me ask you this. If you were a peregrine, or a pigeon rather, being chased by a peregrine, which is the same family as Alderney here, you wouldn't look over your shoulder and go, oh, go on, you're trying ever so hard. Don't even think about it. Good girl. You wouldn't look over your shoulder and go, oh, go on, peregrine, you're trying ever so hard. You've got me this time, would you? You'd be going, absolutely.
And he just stacks those wings and he just cruises around. Good boy. Well done. Excellent. And the reason I wasn't really worried about where he's going to go is because you'll hear that he makes quite a bit of a noise as well. And that's because he's what we call an imprint. So he's really been imprinted on the humans. He knows this field really well. He knows this is home. And you'll see, even though he went off round that way, he's come full circle. Now, the only reason he landed in the trees over there, he took his time coming back, is because you've got to remember, he's just had 3 months off. So he's not very fit at the moment, which is absolutely fine, because we've just got to gradually build him up again. The reason we gave him a bit of time off is because he's only a baby, he's not even a year old yet, this bird, and what he started doing, good boy, keep going, good boy. Is, keep going around, good boy. He's ignoring me today. Now, what he's doing is he's trying to find lift, which is absolutely fine, but the only problem, when they do that, when they're not very fit, is he'll go all the way down there and he's going to stand under the tree. Because what he's doing is he's going right,
she can behave herself. We are up in weight than what we normally are, but she seems to be fly at the highest we possibly want them to. And we're just on that borderline. If she was a couple of grams more, she wouldn't really be keen on flying. But we're doing fine. So Hayes isn't even a year old yet, but she is fully grown. On there. She is fully grown, and she was fully grown from about 12 weeks old. And that means that she can get out and do all the hunting, but have the support of her parents if she needs it. Are you coming? Good girl. So out in the wild, she would eat mice, voles, shrews, anything little like that. And they are one of your nocturnal type of hunters, so you mainly see them out at night. I was very lucky I got to see one on my drive home last night as it was dark. It was just sat in a tree, kind of sat there watching me as I drove past, and I had to resist the temptation to stop my car and go and have a look at it close up. Oh my goodness.